The controversy with Nayong Pilipino and the vaccination facility and business tycoon Ricky Razon, given the fact that we need to vaccinate as many people as we can. Where do you stand on this, Secretary? That in the beginning, Nayong Pilipino had resisted and made it difficult for the Razon group to have a vaccination site put up there.
Well, I have already agreed in principle that this facility will be used temporarily as a huge vaccination center to speed up our vaccination coverage. We really need big areas to wrap up our coverage. No? Hindi pwedeng yung maliliit na lugar. You know, our target is 500,000 a day. No? NCR's target is 120,000 vaccinees a day. So that's how much.
Ang layo natin, that's pretty far, sir.
What do you mean? Ang NCR kasi is 120,000 ang kakayanin nila, assuming adequate supply is, okay. Is there. So kailangan natin yan. I will support the conversion of that area into a huge vaccination site.
Are there other areas right now that other sectors are looking at as a vaccination site, Secretary?
Oh yes, St. Luke's is also looking beyond its hospital confines. No?
Okay.
There's an area, I think, in BGC, Taguig, no? Taguig City, where they plan to put up. And I think there are several initiatives, no? Along that line. And we support all of these initiatives.
All right. Now, something here that needs drastic solutions is the National COVID-19 Vaccinations Operations Center says there are 2 million doses of AstraZeneca that arrived and will expire June and July. So let me read the expiration dates. 1.5 million doses of AstraZeneca will expire on June 30, and 525,000 doses will expire July 31. And we're seeing the rate, no, Secretary? What are you suggesting to make sure that this does not expire? It won't go to waste.
We will make sure nothing will expire. It will all be jabbed. It will all be used for inoculating our A1 to complete the healthcare workers, no? The A2, the senior citizens, and then the adults with comorbidities. No? And of course, based on the WHO prioritization framework, A5 will have to be jabbed the poor, the indigent sector. No? And that's about 20 million.
So okay,
the
yes.
Million is really nothing compared to how much more we need. So we need 3.4 million for the healthcare workers, okay? Then we need 18 million doses for the senior citizens. Uh-oh. Then
what are you seeing, Secretary? Why is it?
We will implement this right away. We will use these easy doses right away. Uh-oh. We already met yesterday with the expert panel members and the WHO. And so we will use everything as first dose. So hindi na kami mag-aantay for the second dose. Yung second dose supply will arrive on the strength and on the commitment of the WHO country representative. And he's going to write a letter to say that the second dose will arrive.
Oo. Kaya ko lang natanong kasi look, right now we are still vaccinating at 40 to 60,000 people a day only. You're talking about, lagay mo na sir, 2 million ang stocks nyo ng Astra. If you calculate 2 million, that's all first dose. If we're hitting 40 to 60,000 a day, they will expire and you won't have, kumbaga, I don't know how you can do the math and say they'll be able to inoculate 2 million people by the end of July.
Kaya yan. No worries. Yeah, we will, you know, marami tayong vaccination sites. Yung nga lang, yung iba na deactivate kasi walang bakuna. You cannot continue to operate the vaccination sites if there are no vaccines. Kaya kumukonti yung sites natin kasi nga depende sa supply. Ngayon na marami supply, we will reactivate
This is a controversial question. At the risk, let's say, close to expiration. Let's say mag-expire na, tapos may natira pa. Would you recommend that anybody willing to get Astra, but they'd have to jump the line, just go to the city, pa-Astra na kayo? I understand you have rules with the COVAX facility, right? They have rules, eh? They're quite strict. But you have many seniors that are still scared. You have many that are not getting vaccinated. I'm just curious how far we will go to make sure nothing goes to waste.
Well, let me just clarify something here now before I answer you. Yung 2 million natin plus, yung 500,000 yan, or 525,600 doses.
Yes.
That will be given a second dose for those who were
very good.
In March, April.
So, okay, thank you for that clarification.
Problema nila 1.5 million. Okay. So yung 1.5 million will all be used as first dose.
Okay.
That's how we're going to implement it.
Uh-oh.
And having said that, we will be able to use all of these before earlier than the expiry date.
You believe with the current system talaga of 40 to 60,000 a day, sir, mauubos yon?
We will ramp up. Kasi nga sabi ko sa iyo, dahil meron na tayo ngayon na bakuna, we will open up more vaccination sites. And we have already identified and in fact accredited mga vaccination sites. Yung nga lang, dahil kulang sa bakuna, mahirap naman yung nagbubukas ka na wala naman ikaw ituturo.
Oo. Okay. I know that there's already Pfizer in some cities, and A4 vaccination priority is not yet open for some areas. Tama, Secretary?
Yes.
Uh-oh. Would you be willing already that A4, that we're talking about commuter transport, public, private, wet, dry market, this is your economic drivers, frontline workers, would you allow them already to start vaccinating A4 using Pfizer?
Oh, well, alam mo, meron tayong prioritization framework and we should abide by this. But as soon as there is enough supply of vaccines, we will already cover the next priority group. So that's A4, the economic frontliners.
Yeah. Yeah.
And within the A4, you have 17 subgroups.
Yes. The reason I'm asking is because some of those in the priority sectors of A1 to 3, like I'll give you an example. My mother, I had to literally convince her to get vaccinated. And I can imagine what many seniors go through, right? So you have many sectors that are priority, that it's such a struggle and a challenge to get them vaccinated. So I'm wondering if at some point, to achieve herd immunity, you will open it up and say, look, please, we need to use these vaccines. Just go and get yourselves vaccinated. I mean, in the United States, it's already at that point, right, Secretary? But that's a whole different example. They have a lot of vaccines. I'm just curious if you're willing to go there already.
Not at this point. We have to follow the COVAX priority framework, lest we lose our receiving the remaining, I think about, I would say about 28 million doses pa yan.
Uh-oh.
That's 7.5 million doses. We only got 2.5 million doses. So the plan kasi is very clear, no? So yung A1 mo, okay, kung may mga ayaw, dahil una sabi natin, Sinovac, hindi pa kasama sa indication doon sa mga senior citizen, no? Tapos eventually, they included it as one of the indications sa Sinovac.
Yes.
And then dahil nakulang, so dumating naman ang AstraZeneca, so we did the same, no? Healthcare workers muna. Now I think we're almost 90%, no? Covered at least yung first dose for the healthcare workers. So we still need to cover for the second dose. And we're probably about more or less 50% pa lang sa second dose. So there's a lot of ground to still cover, Karen. No? So sa dami pa rin ng kailangan bakunahan at sa kakaunti ang bakuna, yung palagay ko, hindi pa natin pwede pag-usapan yung free for all scenario.
Okay. My last question. What is your target vaccination number with 1.5 million doses of AstraZeneca? If we're now hitting 40 to 60,000 a day, do you have a figure, sir, na dapat we have to inoculate 100,000 a day? So lahat ito hindi mag, it won't go to waste.
Well, ang NCR, si Chairman Abalos, has already committed. We are going to put the lion's share of the AZ here in the epicenter, NCR. Right. So they said that they can, they have committed to inoculate 120,000 vaccines per day. Wow. So in 10 days or 15 days, mauubos mo. So that is well, you know, before the expiry date. So we are mindful of the expiration. You know, this is gold. We cannot afford, you know, to be dilly-dallying in terms of implementing our vaccine rollout plan. So we are aggressively pursuing this because, you know, this is one of the part of our arsenal, no? To combat the surge in the NCR. We still have a high daily attack rate, no? More than 7 per 100,000 population. So we need to get that. And so we need to aggressively vaccinate.
Okay. On that note, I want to thank you so much, Secretary Duque, for your time this morning. I appreciate it, sir. And I appreciate the update as well. Thank you.
Thank you very much as well for the invitation. Thank you.
All right. Okay. Stay strong, sir, and you stay safe.